So I wanted to share with you my process of turning a drawing into a holographic vinyl die-cut sticker. I was so close to publishing this video earlier in the year, but since then I have found so much better materials and methods. Therefore, I decided to start over with new and improved techniques. So here it is! I've gotten so many questions about my process and I'm excited to share it with you all. Before we get started, if you want to see more art content like this from me, feel free to hit the like and subscribe button to help me reach my goal of 1,000 subscribers. For this tutorial, I will be using a scanner, inkjet printer, holographic sticker paper, protective laminate, Silhouette Cameo 4 die cut machine, and a Silhouette PixScan mat. First, you want to scan your drawing at a minimum of 300 dpi for best results. If your artwork is digital, obviously you can skip this step. I use Photoshop to make my image background transparent. This step is optional, but I find that a transparent image is much easier to work with in the Silhouette software, and the background is out of the way. When you do this, make sure you save your image out as a PNG so that it has a transparent background. I will link the Photoshop tutorial in the comments for those who are interested. Now your file is ready for the Silhouette software. Before importing your image, make sure your page and print settings match up with your paper. My sticker paper is 8.5 by 11, so I want to set the media size to match that, as well as the settings under File, Print Page Setup. Now you can import your file and just position it wherever you want on the page. My stickers are around 3 by 4 inches, so I usually have 4 per page. Now you're going to select the trace panel that looks like a butterfly and select the trace area. Adjust the threshold so that most of your design is filled with yellow, then select trace. Then you're going to select the offset panel further down that looks like a star, and this will give you the die cut line you are looking for. You can adjust the distance to whatever looks best. I try not to leave any awkward gaps when I do this, then hit apply. Drag your image away and delete your original trace line, leaving your offset die cut outline. You can use an eraser tool to erase any gaps you don't want in your sticker. Up to you what you want to keep in, but personally, I think those are unnecessary. You can drag your image back to the center of the die cut line and center it with alignment tools. And assuming that the rest of your stickers are the same size and design, you can duplicate and center the die cut lines for the rest of your stickers on the sheet as well. You can also select Ctrl G to group your image and your die cut line to prevent them from separating. Make sure your die cut lines are not too close to the print border, and we're going to go ahead and check that real quick. And don't worry, these red lines will not show up in your print. So go ahead and load up your printer with the sticker paper. This is what I use. I've tried at least 3 different styles of holographic paper, and this one has been my favorite so far. It's very sturdy and it sticks to just about everything. I'll put a link in the description below. I use a Canon PIXMA Pro 9000 Mark II inkjet printer for my high quality prints. Because this is an inkjet printer, I have to seal my sticker sheet with a protective layer so they're protected from water and UV rays, so people can put them on their water bottles, on whatever they want, and it'll be protected from all that stuff. There are several options to waterproof your stickers, but I prefer using the Oracal OraGuard self-laminate sheets. I have seen some YouTube videos where artists will use a laminating machine to seal their stickers. However, when I tried this, it wasn't very effective. Then again, my laminator is super old. So in the future, when I get around to replacing my laminator, I might see better results. I'll tell you what, I'll make a new video once I find out. The best way I've found to apply your protective laminate by hand is to tape your printed sheet, preferably on a slanted surface like I have here. I have a drafting table, and slowly apply the laminate with a ruler edge and a squeegee to remove any air bubbles. Sometimes I have to allow the sheet to rest for a day if I'm unable to remove the air bubbles, and then it usually goes away. Now it's ready for the die cut machine. For the longest time, I used to print out registration marks on my sticker sheets and use a traditional Silhouette method of scanning the registration marks to position a cut. However, for some reason, the Silhouette is super terrible at reading the markings, maybe because the paper is so shiny and it messes with the laser, I don't know. I've tried everything from putting tape over the registration marks, printing registration marks, but it's just been super frustrating. Until I have found this method where you can use a Silhouette PixScan mat, and it made things so much easier. All you have to do is place your sticker paper within the black rectangle on the mat, and you can upload it to the Silhouette software by scanning or taking a picture with your phone. I don't have a scanner large enough for this mat, so I just use my phone, which is fine. You just have to make sure you properly calibrate your phone camera to the Silhouette software, and I'll link that tutorial in the description as well. So if you're using your phone, go ahead and take a picture. As long as your mat is on a flat surface, your camera does not have to be exactly parallel to your mat. The software will calibrate that difference for you. In Silhouette Studio, select the PixScan panel to import your image from Google Drive or however you want to send it to your computer. And from here, double check that everything looks good and that the sticker paper is aligned in your rectangle in the position that it looks like in person. Now you can drag one of the die cut groups from your previous file over to your PixScan file. It should be the same size, so there's no need to resize anything, but you may have to rotate the die cut line. A little tip, if you hold down Shift, it will snap the rotation in 90 degree increments. Use your keyboard directional keys to align your die cut line directly over the PixScan image. Go ahead and duplicate and align this 3 more times on your canvas. Now that your die cut lines look good, head over to the Send tab. These are my cut settings. They're kind of extreme, but you have to remember that we are cutting through a protective laminate, the sticker paper, and the sticker backing. So through trial and error, this is what I found to work best for me. I highly suggest starting out with these settings using the test button and then adjusting them from there if need be. Double check that all your die cut lines are highlighted red, then load up your mat and hit send. I find that I have to kind of hold the mat as it scans or else it'll actually slide off, but from here you can let it cut. Once your designs are cut, lay your mat face down over the protective cover to prevent curling and peel off your stickers. And there you have it, your very own homemade vinyl holographic sticker. If you're interested in this sticker, you can buy this and others on my online store, joycerainbowart.com. Also, feel free to follow me on social media, where I'll have all these links listed in the description. Thank you so much for watching. This was my very first video and I had a ton of fun making it. If you use this tutorial to make your own stickers, feel free to leave a comment below.